I've done several videos on arthritis now and the management of arthritis through nutrition and through exercise. And in this video, I want to talk about a particular mineral that may be deficient in your diet and may be slowing down or hindering your healing process. And that is boron. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I am an arthritis sufferer. I had really bad hip arthritis. You may have seen the videos. I was scheduled for a hip replacement. I put it off and addressed the issue through weight management and through nutrition and through exercise, and now I am running 10 kilometers again on a regular basis on my original hip, and they have no plans for a hip replacement. So it can be done. Arthritis can be managed and it can be, in a lot of cases, reversed. There's a debate about whether it's curable or not. I've done a video on that. I'm going to link that at the end of this video so you can understand what the argument is actually about. But boron is a trace element, a mineral that should be in our food and sometimes is not, because the soil that a lot of the food that we eat is grown in is depleted in boron. And that goes not just for eating plants that are grown in the soil. If you're eating animal products and the animals have been eating plants that are growing in deficient soil, you're going to have the same issue. So what does boron do? Boron is very important for bone health and bone growth, in that it is a facilitator to the processes of vitamin D and magnesium, which are controlling the calcium in and out of your bones, so the health of your bones. If you have osteopenia or osteoporosis, now osteoporosis is brittle bones that are low in calcium and they get below a certain level and it's considered to be osteoporosis. Osteopenia is a process of losing calcium over a period of time. So osteopenia is the progressive loss of calcium and osteoporosis is the result eventually of the process of osteopenia. So that's the difference. And vitamin D is very important to regulate the calcium going into your bones, and magnesium plays a very crucial role in that as well. But without boron, if you're deficient in boron, the vitamin D is not going to be as effective and your magnesium is probably going to be low, because your absorption of magnesium from your food is affected if you are deficient in boron. So these are complicated issues with knock-on effects, but really, you need to ensure that your boron level is high enough. Now, you don't need a lot of boron. So I'm not suggesting we all run out and buy boron supplements. If you're eating a lot of avocados, for example, or a lot of almonds, they are pretty high in boron and it might not be an issue. But if you're not sure and you think it might be, and you're taking supplements with magnesium or vitamin D3 anyway, see if you can get one that also has traces of boron in it. You really don't need more than 1 to 3 milligrams of boron a day, but you can get supplements that include boron for bone growth and bone maintenance, for the healing process. So that will affect you if you have arthritis, which is inflammation of the joints. Vitamin D efficiency, magnesium absorption, it does help to lower inflammation, and boron actually plays a role in brain function as well. So there you go. Osteoporosis, osteopenia, osteoarthritis. Make sure that you are either eating enough food with boron in it, or just take a tiny little supplement, get a magnesium vitamin D3 supplement that includes boron. It's very often the little magic missing ingredient. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please share this video and please watch my other videos on arthritis and how you can manage your arthritis and possibly avoid surgery.